Hi, I'm Chad Gillespie, Senior Manager of Performance Construction for Mitsubishi Electric, and I have the pleasure today to be here with Luis Imery, who is the owner of the Imery Group. He is a high-performance builder for us, and we really have a special project here that we want to talk about today. It's in process now, and you know, Luis, tell us a little bit about this project and what the goals were for this project.
Yeah, so we got a call from a client all about high performance. And high performance or green building or whatever, it's actually the result of doing everything right the first time and paying attention to the details. And by default, you get all these benefits. And one key factor that we incorporate into our designs in order to capture those low-hanging fruit that Mother Nature gives us is site location placement.
Sure.
Okay. So understanding how the sun is going to be moving in relation with the house and all that allow us to make incorporate a lot of passive solar design into the house.
So Luis, we're downstairs here. We're in the main living room of this house, and I see a lot of interesting things we'll probably talk about. We've got the kitchen area here. So, you know, why don't you start about more of the concepts of the air sealing that you talked about and how you've made this house tight, and then we can go on to some of the other mechanical concepts.
Sure. So yeah, this is, let's say, the amenity, the common area of the house, kitchen, the dining, living, and all that. So on the air sealing side of the equation for this house or any part of the house, there are some critical spots that we address a little bit differently. Here we use cellulose for the above grade walls, but we have bands. Bands are very difficult areas to insulate properly.
And that's okay. The area between the first floor and the second
Correct.
Floor.
Where the floor system hits that exterior section of the house.
Right. That's one of the leakiest parts of above
Correct,
grade
because
house.
You have penetrations, you have a lot of things, blockings and things. So that's a good strategy for high performance home to say, well, let's not think about that and just use a insulation material that it's an air barrier.
Right.
In our case is open cell foam.
Right.
So we have R21 on the bands, and that helps. That couple with the R3 sheathing that we have on the exterior gives us a properly insulated and air seal section.
So that cellulose is not only working as the insulation but as the sealant too.
Yeah,
for those cracks and crevices.
The open cell foam.
Good, yeah. Good. Excellent. So let's look at some of the fun stuff here when it comes to mechanical, because we see some ductwork, we see some different things, and I know you've got some interesting details about the plumbing and some things. So can you tell us a little bit about what we have here?
So in this area, which is the open area, could have been treated with maybe two additional wall-mounted heads, mm-hmm. but the numbers worked out better to have a ducted mini split. Okay. So that's why you see ducts in the floor system here.
Right.
They're short run ducts connected to a mini split BRF system, all right, distributing into the living room, kitchen, and dining room. Those ducts are all piped with rigid metal, mastic, and sealed. We expect this home, once we do the duct blaster test, which is the air sealing of the duct, to be less than 4%. That's our target.
Because you're going to get a very comfortable house with this situation. And so again, I think you had told me that you want to use minimal ductwork, again, for less chance to trap filter, allergens, things like that. Is that correct?
Yeah, so our way of building is delivering a healthy, durable, efficient, and comfortable home. So on the healthy side of the equation, we're very mindful of controlling dust and VOCs and all those type of airborne particles that will have a negative impact on human health.
Sure. And so I see you've insulated your hot water runs as well?
Correct. So right behind is where we're putting a split heat pump water heater. So that's why you see, which is very unusual, a line set being run where the water heater is, and that line set goes actually to one of your Mitsubishi hyperheat compressor,
right,
multi-port, because we're combining that water heater with the excess capacity that we have on the compressor in order to heat the water.
Right, so this is an integrated system. So this is not a self-contained hot water heater or heat pump hot water heater. It's actually connected to the HVAC system and recovers energy. And
so you have a piece of equipment that it's already a heat pump. Why not maximize the use? Because you have the option of capturing that excess, not excess capacity, given that we have VRF technology and everything dials down to the load, you can always draw from those. Having a split water heater also makes the area easier in installation because you don't have to worry about noise,
right?
You know, if that is a concern.
Right. Excellent.
And good. Then with the hot water, so that addresses the efficiency of the heating water.
Sure.
A traditional electric water heater is 0.95 energy factor. A heat pump water heater, depending on this one, could be between 2.5 and 3.5, so almost triple.
Right.
All right.
Efficiency. Okay.
But then there's the hot water distribution. If you have a pipe, a hot water pipe, that it's filled with hot water, if you're it's not being used, it's gonna cool down.
Right.
So then when you turn your fixture, it needs to drain it and all that. So by insulating the hot water line and controlling the length of your pipe distribution, you save water and you make the time of delivery of the hot water much quicker.
Excellent. Okay. So Luis, we're in one of the guest bedrooms here. So kind of tell us what your plan was here for the conditioning and air movement through the bathroom.
So up here, upstairs, what we decided to do is use ductless mini splits. So behind me, you see the line set for a small in-wall unit, okay, which would condition this bedroom, all right? And on my left, you have the bathroom. So on top of the door, you see a transfer grill,
okay.
And that's how we condition the rest of the area that perhaps is not conditioned directly.
Right.
So in a bathroom, every bathroom has an exhaust fan, right?
Right?
So every time you go in, you flip the switch, so you create negative pressure in the bathroom. So that's gonna allow air to move in and out off the bathroom.
So that small fan is gonna pull some of the conditioned air in this room into the bathroom so you keep a normalized temperature.
Correct. Okay. And in this design for a high performance home, those bath fans are rigged with a in-wall condensation sensor. So
okay.
That bath fan, no matter what the user decides to do, will always run until humidity is under control.
Gotcha.
In addition, on this wall in front of me, we have a whole house dehumidifier, which also is helping in keeping indoor moisture down and relative humidity.
Right.
As you build tighter homes, moisture content becomes something that you have to be more aware
sure.
and manage.
I do have one question too. This is always, we get this a lot, is can a house be too tight? Because I think I know the answer to that, but I think for other people, can you build a house too tight?
You can never build, it's always gonna leak. So it's a matter of controlling where that leak is coming from.
Right.
We do that by incorporating an ERV, an energy recovery ventilator. So
right.
That's our source
of fresh air.
Bringing fresh air. For this particular house, we decided to use a dedicated ERV manufactured by Braun. So we're pulling air from the exterior, we're exhausting, and then we're dumping into the house.
So to make it clear for some people who don't know what an ERV is, what basically you're saying is that you bring in fresh air from the outside and then you're exhausting without losing a ton of energy, the bad air that's in your house from cooking or baths or stuff like that.
Correct.
Okay, excellent. Well, that makes a lot of sense. Hey, one other question. So what was the reason you chose Mitsubishi's own comfort solutions for this project?
Well, it's a no-brainer. I've been using Mitsubishi equipment since 2010 and I've never had a problem. It allowed the opportunity to create multiple zones in order to reduce the electric demand and increase the comfort on the house.
Excellent. Very good.